In this chapter, we will introduce you to the configuration panel of the system. To access it, click on Menu and then on Settings. The setup panel will pop up. The setup panel is divided in 7 categories. Each of the categories contain subcategories that will link you to the desired configuration interface. The categories are very logical, so if you are not sure where to find the settings you are looking for, just follow your instinct and most probably you will get to where you want to go. Let's introduce the categories. First is the camera settings. This category offers all configuration related to the cameras. The subcategories are Add Camera, for adding cameras to the system, Edit Camera, for editing parameters for existing cameras, Image Settings, for adjusting the camera image and other parameters related to it, such as flip and mirror, Motion, setting the motion detection, area and sensitivity, PTZ, configuring PTZ cameras, including presets and cruises. Next, we will have Record Settings. This is where you will set your recording, including resolution, bit rate, and substream. The subcategories are Record, for setting the record method and manual record duration, Encoding Parameters. Here, you will be able to set all the recording parameters for each of the cameras, including substream settings. Recording Schedule, setting and applying schedules for the different recording triggers. Advances, setting the pre and post alarm recording durations. After record, we have alarm settings. Here you will find all the configuration regarding alarms, including alarms inputs and outputs. The subcategories are Alarm Out, set and text the alarm outputs of the system and related cameras. Motion Alarm, set the triggers and responses of the system to motion alarms. Sensor Alarm, to set the triggers and responses of the system to sensor alarms. Exception, to set the triggers and responses of the system to exception alarms. And Alarm Status, showing the status of all alarms available in the system. Next, we have Disk Settings. This is where you will see all the information concerning hard disks. You will also be able to assign recording groups from here. The subcategories are Disk Management, to see the available hard drives and format, if needed. Storage Mode. Here you will be able to set recording groups and assign specific cameras for specific hard drives. Disk Information. Here, you will be able to see all the information regarding your hard drives. Next is Network Settings. This section allows all network configurations. The subcategories are TCP/IPv4. From here, you will set the IP address of the device. DDNS. Configure the DDNS service for the device. Ports. Set the HTTP, data, and RTSP ports of the device. Email. Configure email address for sending email notifications. UPnP. Set UPnP connection. NAT. Enable cloud access connection. Telnet. Enable temporary telnet connection for special maintenance. Network status. This summarizes all the network information and details. Next, we'll have account and authority settings. This category relates to all settings of users and authorities. The subcategories are Add User, for adding new users to the system, Edit Users, editing existing users on the system, Edit Permission Group, creating or editing permission groups that will be used for users of the system, Modify Password, for modifying password for existing users, and Online User, showing connected users and their current usage of the system. Last, we'll have the system settings. From here, we will set all the basic configurations of the system. We will also be able to update, backup, and restore settings for the system. The subcategories are Basic. This will set all the basic values for the system, such as output resolutions, video system, etc. Date and time. to set the time zone, DST, and adjust the time and date, system information, to view all the crucial information of the system, view log, to access the system logs and search within it, backup and restore, to backup and restore the system settings, and upgrade. Here you update the system's firmware to the latest one. This was a general introduction to the settings interface. In the next chapters, we will go deeper into each of the categories.